Addition reaction. We have seen couple of reactions, what are called addition, what are called substitution, elimination, and now one more or reaction which we are going to add in our knowledge, that is addition reaction. What are the addition reaction? Their introduction, types of addition reaction, orientation and reactivity, along with that some of the examples we are going to learn today. So as the name suggests, addition. So addition is not a new word for us to understand. Basically, addition means 1 plus 2 equal to this 3. Right? So that way, addition is nothing is deleted. If we ask some reaction such as substitution, so something is replaced by something. So that is called substitution. In other words, it is called as displacement reaction. Here, the addition is a concept where we are going to learn there is only something is going to add into the our reactants. Nothing is going to be removed. Nothing is going to be, let us say, deleted or eliminated from our reaction component. That's why this addition reactions are more important. Just like we are adding 1 plus 1, so that will become 2. There is no subtraction, there is no displacement, or there is no elimination. So it is totally called addition reaction. Just like a general mathematics, simple mathematics, we can figure out this addition. So let us go to the addition reaction. Basically, it is defined as a particular reaction in which all the reagent atoms are added to the reactant. So that is a kind of what we can call it is as an somehow addition. And thus, the product contains all the atoms of the reactants as well as those of the reagent. Means whatsoever the reagents were present, what's in the our starting materials, the same they shall be present into our products. So this is the major difference for what is called addition reaction. And other reactions such as displacement, where something is knocked out, something is removed, something is in, something has arrived. So that is called displacement substitution reaction. Some reactions which are called, let us say, elimination. So in elimination, you know, these are the synthesis of alkenes from alkyl halides. So where alkenes are going to be formed by somehow kinds of elimination of living group. But here in this case, there will be no living group as well. So these are the characteristics features for unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated compounds means what? Likewise, we can call them as carbon-carbon double bond containing compounds. Or we can call unsaturated alkenes, olefins. So these are the reactions, addition reactions are majorly the characteristics of unsaturated olefin. Friends, these are the types of the addition reaction. Let us say electrophilic addition, nucleophilic addition, free radical addition, and addition to the conjugated system. So, depending upon whether it is electrophile, whether it is nucleophile, whether it is free radical, these addition reactions are classified. Electrophilic addition, where majorly the electrophilic species, electrophiles, are involved in the reaction. Nucleophilic addition, where nucleophiles are involved. You very well know what are called nucleophiles, the reactive species which are in search of positively charged centered species. So those species itself, they will be negatively charged and will be in search of positive charged species. Electrophilic species means they are in search of electrons. They are in search of nuclear electrons, negatively charged species. But to have a felicity towards the negatively charged species, they themselves should be positive. So these are the way we can classify electrophilic addition reaction and nucleophilic addition reaction. The third type of the reaction, what we used to call it, is this basically nucleophilic, free radical addition. So free radical addition are those reactions where generally we are involved, there is involvement of free radical. As the name suggests, free, so that these are the, just like we, the people of country, India, are free in nature. So we have our liberty, we have our rights to think, we have our rights to speak, our rights to propose whatever our idea in a public domain. So there is no kind of restriction for a free country. On other side, anything which is free is dangerous. Because if people are free, then वो किसी का भी आगे चल के खून कर देंगे और आगे चल के किसी को भी मार देंगे या किसी को कुछ का कुछ बोल देंगे. So that way, free is always a kind of indication that although there are rights of, there are people have basic rights, but anything which is free, that is always dangerous, right? So what I want to say for this free radicals, that basically free radical are the reactive species, and here they are having lot of energies and they are highly energetic and reactive. Anything which comes into their road or anything which comes into their path, they will vigorously react with this. So that's why I want to indicate this word, the free, which is totally, although it is a good word, but there are so many limitations, there are so many disadvantages of being free. But if you are, let us say, in someone's control, and that will really add to a good feature for your whatever you say. Right? So free radicals are the react, in chemistry point of view, they are the reactive species having an odd electron, an extra electron, single electron, and because of which they are highly energetic, highly reactive, and can cause several addition reactions. Okay, so these are the we can call them as unstable reactive species. Now I'm going to touch upon all of these free radical addition reactions and electrophilic or nucleophilic addition, starting from this, the first topic, electrophilic addition. So there are two kinds of words in this reaction. One is called electrophilic, and another word is addition. So electrophilic is basically means a kind of reactive species such as Y plus, which is presented hypothetically in this reaction, which means somehow kind of electrifying. Such as if we have alkene, so alkene is going to react with Y plus, which is basically our electrophile El plus, and that is slowly going to form this reactive species called as carbocation. And we know these are the carbocations, are the species which are where the carbon is having positively charged, and that is going to react. And how they are going to form? So friends, basically this is a carbon double bond containing compound, alkene, which is source of electron. So source of electron is going to react through one of the end, and that is going to reach to this Y plus, and this way this carbocation is. And then what will happen, that it is a kind of addition reaction. So Y plus, which was conjugated with W minus. So now here is a case where this W minus is going to interact with the positively charged carbocation, and thus it will form a carbon-carbon single bond containing compound. So look at to the structure. Initially it was having a carbon-carbon double bond, but in the end it is having carbon-carbon single bond. So there are two steps involved in this reaction, where WY, which is basically a reactant which is going to react with this alkene, and that is going to form this unsaturated, this is going to form this saturated bonds. On your this left hand side, it was unsaturated alkene, and here now it is saturated alkene. So this reaction is termed as addition reaction, because W was added to this reactant, Y was also added to the reactant. Nothing is lost. because in this reaction there is nothing called leaving groups. You know what are called leaving groups? You have visited several leaving groups, chloride, bromide, fluoride, iodide, in your elimination, in your substitution chapters. But here, friends, nothing is going to lose. We are going, the reaction mein kisi ka bhi loss nahin hota hai, but only there is something called addition. W minus was added to one carbon, Y plus was also added to the another carbon. So that way, this reactions are termed as addition. Why it is called electrophilic? It is called as electrophilic reaction because the reaction was started through the presence of this Y plus, which is basically a positively charged electrophile. Okay, that's why this reaction is termed as electrophilic and addition. Okay. Now I'm going to show this with a practical example with what is called bromine. This is a simplest reaction where alkene is also symmetrical in nature because we can cut alkene into two equal parts. Another molecule that is also bromine, that is also Br2, and this bromine is also a symmetrical atom because we can also cut bromine into two equal parts. So how the way addition will occur? Addition will occur in such a way that you can see that there are two pi clouds or pi bonds in this carbon-carbon double bond. One bond, in fact, one bond is called a sigma bond and one bond is called as a pi bond. So pi bond, ka jo pi cloud hai, that is going to interact with this bromine and thus it is going to form a cyclic bromonium ion such as this. How it will form? Because this one of the carbon of bromine that will attack on this, and the lone pair on the head of the bromine that will attack the other carbon, positively charged carbon, to form this cyclic bromonium ion. Why it is called bromonium ion? Because here Br minus has already departed from this way and it has resulted in the formation of this Br plus. So that way this three-membered cyclic bromonium ion is formed, and this three-membered cyclic bromonium ion is now a reactive species. So this reactive species is naturally, if you remember, I used to call always in my class that charge localization destabilizes the molecule and charge delocalization stabilizes the molecule. This is a reactive species having a positive charge, having a localized charge. So that's why it is unstable in nature. So what will happen? To stabilize this, Br minus, which is again a nucleophilic character, a nucleophilic species, so that will attack on any one of this carbon and thus this cyclic ring will broken up. So you can see that bromonium ion, which is going to attack on this carbon, and this three-membered ring will open up. And the opening of this three-membered ring will end up in this 1,2-dibromo. It is suggested here that this addition is always a kind of anti-addition, because on one hand side bromine will attack and on another side bromine will depart. So it may lead to the formation of, yahan pe thoda galti ho gayi hai, if this is not a carbon-carbon single bond, here it should be a double bond, here it should be a carbon-carbon single bond such as this. Okay, so hence we will have this kind of a product. What is, and that is obtained through anti-addition, means addition of bromide ion will always happen at the other end, and that will lead to the formation of this 1,2-dibromo. So we are going to learn the stereochemistry point of view that how these things can be possible. So always remember that whenever there is an anti-addition, product will be 3O. And if there is a syn addition, then product will be erythro. Now, how to remember this 3O and erythro? In fact, what is the, we have always, these are the kinds of carbon-carbon double bonds and something which are going to be added from this carbon species. So here they have mentioned that if it is an addition on a same site, it is called as erythro. That either on this carbon if Y is added or on this carbon W is added, but addition across the same side of carbon-carbon double bond will result in erythroisomer. And this erythro and 3-O are nothing. They basically are given the kind of nomenclature from sugar chemistry, because in sugar this four-membered carbohydrates are called as erythros and 3-Os. So erythro means on same side. So on the carbon-carbon double bond, if there is a same side addition, it is called as erythro. On carbon-carbon double bond, if one is added from the top side, other is added from the bottom side. So this kind of addition is exactly called as 3-O. And that is basically will have always happen in opposite fashion, in opposite manner. So erythro and 3-O are these are the two major kinds of concepts which can be. In the same way, the stereochemistry is also applicable to carbon-carbon compounds. Now we are going to look at upon another kind of addition, which is called as nucleophilic addition. Although I have not touched very much important kind of reaction, perhaps let me look at to that, so I can also further discuss with you regarding this. Marconi-Kaurula is there, so that we will visit. So coming back to this topic, where how the way electrophilic addition is possible, and now the counterpart of electrophilic addition, that is called nucleophilic addition. So I hope that up to electrophilic addition the things will be clear. And now the another counterpart of this addition reaction, that is called nucleophilic addition reaction, we are going to. So as the name suggests, nucleophilic addition. So nucleophilic addition are the kinds of addition where always there will be addition of a nucleophilic character first. And always remember, nucleophilic species will have attraction towards the positively charged species. But to have the attraction towards positively charged species itself, they should be negatively charged. And then the attack of this will happen. And isme nucleophilic addition mein, there shall be always formation of कार्बन आयन कैरेक्टर. ओके, आप इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक एडिशन को याद करो तो देयर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ रिएक्टिव स्पीशीज व्हिच आर कॉल्ड एज कार्बोकैटायन. एंड इन दिस केस देयर शैल बी द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सम रिएक्टिव स्पीशीज व्हाट आर कॉल्ड कार्बन आयन. सो बेसिकली कार्बन व्हिच आर हैविंग द नेगेटिव चार्ज, सो कार्बन आयन इज गोइंग टू, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर टर्म एज कार्बन आयन कैरेक्टर. And carbo, previously we visited carbocation character. Okay, क्योंकि यहाँ पर negative charge था, this was a basically a neutral species, this is a negatively charged species, दोनों के बीच में reaction होता है, तो product is also negatively charged. The negatively charged species is going to react with the positively charged species, and thus it is going to form this alkane. And that is happening through. These are the species what are called nucleophilic addition. Okay, so this is basically a nucleophilic addition reaction, and sometimes depending upon, although I'm not going to touch this, but this is also applicable to alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, and majorly वहाँ पर 1,4 nucleophilic addition is possible. 1,2 addition भी उसको बोलते हैं और 1,4 addition भी उसको. So this addition is basically called as, although इसमें 1 और 4 का scope ही नहीं है, 1 और 2 का ही scope है, क्योंकि if we label this as carbon number 1, that is in carbon will become carbon number. Okay. So this way, this 1,4 addition में क्या होता है कि हमारे पास alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound होता है. So our Y minus which will first add to the fourth position, and then this H plus is going to add at the second position. Basically, this is 1,2 addition, जहाँ पे दोनों carbonyl carbon will remain as such. So this reaction is basically called as one for nucleophilic addition reaction, because वहाँ पर fourth position, this fourth position is also. Okay, so we are not going to touch upon in this in detail, but we just have to remember that this nucleophilic addition that will happen through the carbon ionic mechanism, and this is basically non-stereospecific and stereoselective reaction. Okay, so this is the way, as you can see, a carbon-carbon double bond containing compound Y minus will be added to any one of this, and it will be like this. So carbon ion is formed, and this carbon ion is going to react with some other species to form. So this reaction is not only possible with let us say carbon-carbon double bond as well, but sometimes the same kinds of reactions are also possible with carbon-carbon triple bond containing compounds. Okay, so it is possible with acetylene. Acetylene is nothing but carbon-carbon triple bond containing compound, which is that exists in the form of a gaseous molecule. Okay, so here in the presence of addition of HCN, basically hydrogen cyanide, which can happen to this carbon-carbon triple bond containing compound, and that will form this acrylonitrile. And this acrylonitrile is more important in the formation of this rubber. Apne naam suna ho to, during this acrylonitrile, which is used as a polymer, and polyacrylonitriles, and these are used in the formation of some polymers. Carbon-carbon triple bond, and in the presence of OH minus, if there are certain kinds of addition of alcohol, such as methanol, so thus it may lead to the formation of this vinyl methyl. So this reaction is also termed as this kind of. Okay, so basically this is free radical addition reaction, which will happen in the presence of electrophilic addition, and one more addition that we have termed, that is called free radical. Electrophilic addition reaction we have seen, then we have seen nucleophilic addition, and the last most part of the reaction, that is addition. Now, before we go to electrophilic addition, I would like to share some one of the documentary with you people, so that we can educate ourselves with this Marconico or anti-Marconico addition. Although Marconico addition,
in this tutorial,
they are not something new to you, but you people have already visited during your plus one and plus two science, and this is simply as also kind of electrophilic addition. Okay, so what are called these reactions? So Marconico addition reaction, basically, which is anti-Marconico bhi hum seekenge, because these are more important to and concepts to learn our basics. So how this is there? So basically, we know something called symmetry. We have in our electrophilic addition today we have learned that topic, in which we have just added symmetrical bromo containing compounds to the alkenes. There can be also possibly the addition of asymmetric hydrogen halides, hydrogen bromides, hydrogen chlorides, even hydrogen fluorides and hydrogen iodides to the carbon-carbon double bond containing species. Okay, so that asymmetric addition is also possible, and the people are learning this in the form of, let us say, something what is called Marconico addition and anti-Marconico. Okay, so let us first visit, before visiting the name of the scientist, I would like to introduce you people regarding this major concepts. Okay, so in which first we will visit what are called several of these reactions, and among these reactions, I hope that screen shall be visible to you people. Is it visible there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, can you see the images, whatever are there? or it is simply blank. Just a minute, let me stop the way I am sharing it. I am going to reshare with you people the total full screen so that hopefully may be able to see the screen. Okay. So coming to this anti-Markovnikov kind of this. And Markovnikov addition we have to also learn today. So basically it is kind of addition of HBr to the alkenes. So generally the reaction is like this, where alkene which is going to react with HBr, and thus it shall be forming, let us say, RCOOR, and it may react with alkyl. So regioselectivity is one of the main concern over here, that when we are dealing with asymmetrical alkenes. Asymmetrical alkenes such as this, 2-butene we can call that, or 2-methyl propene. So in that case, this is totally asymmetrical one, and HBr is there, so there will be formation of two products. One of them may be this one, where hydrogen is added to CH terminal less substituted carbon, and other product is the one where hydrogen of HBr has added to this terminal carbon, where more number of hydrogens were attached. So basically we can call them as the two kinds of the products. One of is basically Markovnikov addition, and other is called as anti-Markovnikov addition. Okay, so how, why such things are there? Although they have mentioned that Markovnikov addition does not require any kind of presence of peroxide, but this anti-Markovnikov addition that requires the presence of somehow peroxides. What are called peroxides? Peroxides are majorly species where oxygen is connected with oxygen. Just like aapka jo water molecule aap the daily intake major water like also, or it contains only one oxygen atom which is connected with two hydrogen atoms. But these are the species where two oxygen atoms are connected with each other. If you remember the structure of hydrogen peroxide, so hydrogen peroxide per it basically hydrogen per oxide. So if you, what is the meaning of per oxide? Peroxide ka meaning wahi hota, it is having additional oxygen. Per means additional, extra, more. So that way these peroxides are having carbon-carbon. It may be hydrogen peroxide, it may be dimethyl peroxides or whatever. And these peroxides are the major source for the formation of free radical. Anti-Markovnikov addition may free radical formation. Markovnikov addition may basically relatively slow, but here it is always formed through. So here they are showing the mechanism for this, but if I shall hold it down and will bring you back to certain few slides where to explain basically this Markovnikov addition kaise hota hai. So Markovnikov addition mein generally this carbon carbon jo hydrogen hai, as generally it is thought like that hydrogen is going to add to the carbon which possess more number of atoms. So jiske paas sabse zyada hydrogen atom hai, usi ke paas there shall be addition of this carbon carbon addition of the hydrogen, and bromine is going to attach to the less substituted carbon. तो सब, और इन अदर वर्ड्स जो अनसब्स्टिट्यूटेड कार्बन है उस पे हाइड्रोजन का एडिशन होता है, और जो लेस सब्स्टिट्यूटेड कार्बन है और द मोर सब्स्टिट्यूटेड कार्बन है उस पे ब्रोमीन का एडिशन होता है. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड Markovnikov एडिशन, एंड दिस प्रोडक्ट्स आर जनरली मोर स्टेबल, एंड दीज आर फॉर्म इन मेजर अमाउंट व्हेन वी आर नॉट यूजिंग. What will happen when we use the peroxides. Whenever we shall be using the peroxide, so these peroxides, as I have told you, they are source of free radicals. So peroxides, in the presence of light, in the presence of heat, they are going to form these kinds of free radicals, and this free radical will react with our HBr, which is basically asymmetric species, and they will form this alcohol, and along with that there shall be formation of a bromine radical. So these are the steps which are called as initiation. So something which are called reactions for which initiations are there, and there are certain kinds of the reactions where elimination is also possible. Okay, so initiation ek pehla step hota hai, and then after that other step what is called propagation. So as you can see, propagation means to propagate the formation of free radical from one of the reactive species to the other reactive species. Jaise ki in this case, one of the bromine radical which reacts with the hydrogen of carbon-carbon double bond containing compound, and thus it shall be forming this another radical. Okay, so this way we have discussed that these radicals are always shown with the help of single-headed arrow. So thus they will be forming this bromine radical. And now next, if it is formed like this, then bromine radical will be reacting with another molecule of alkene like this to form this radical species. Fine. So this way the propagation will occur where the previously generated bromine radical will react with the alkene molecule like this, will form this alkyl radical. And this alkyl radical, which is tertiary alkyl radical, more stable, which is formed faster, so that will react with another molecule of HBr to form this this addition product, and or we can call it adduct as well as bromine radical. So termination possibilities, jaise wo the third most step is the termination, initiation, propagation, and the termination. So these are the major three steps, and the final step is called as termination. So what are, how the way this the reaction is going to terminate? So either two bromine radicals will react with each other to form the bromine, or maybe any one of the alkyl radical will react with another alkyl radical to form this product, or else this bromine is going to, alkyl radical is going to react with bromine radical to form this. So this way this reaction will occur, and which is called as basically termination. So initiation, from where we started our reaction, propagation, where we from where we have ended in our more than one kind of the species formation, and termination is a step where we totally have ended our reactions. So you can see on the screen that how the way anti-Marconi coaddition and Marconi coaddition which is being. So Marconi coaddition mein hydrogen coaddition wahan par hota hai ki jahan pe least na sabse zyada hydrogen attach hota hai wahi pe hydrogen ka attachment hota hai. Aur anti-Marconi co mein usse ulta hota hai ki jahan pe hydrogen ka addition udhar hota hai ki jahan pe the carbon is less substituted. Or more substituted. Okay, so anti-Marconi coaddition of hydrogen hydrogen halide is unique for the HBr, and the same way it is not applicable to the addition of HCl and hydrogen iodide. The reason is for that, kyunki jab hum HBr lete hain tab dono jo step, alkyl radical formation or addition of hydrogen halide, both the steps are electron exothermic in nature. But if we compare this chlorine and with addition of hydrogen chloride, hydrogen iodide, hydrogen fluoride, then second step is either positive in case of HCl, and in the first step this hydrogen iodide addition is where endothermic in nature. Endothermic reactions where we will have to supply the energy from external source, and then exothermic reactions where this is going. So they are going to summarize that our alkene is going to react with HBr and thus it will be forming this kind of product. It is a radical chain reaction, anti-Marconi coaddition, and only applicable to hydrogen. So with this, we are going to stop for today. And basically, we have learned so many kinds of the reactions where what are called this substitutions reaction, elimination reaction, and how they are different from this kinds of anti-Marconi and Marconi reaction. So that we discuss. Let us stop up with this, and we will continue our discussion in.